It doesn't mean anything because we still tried. Let's go. Oh, what the f- Man, I knew it, bruh. I knew it, bruh. Ain't no way. Ain't no way, bruh. Ain't no way, bruh. Oh my god. You know what? What the fuck? What the fuck?
Hello. This script is being written on the 4th of July as opposed to the 5th, so the introduction of this video serves as a comedy hook. If you don't want to hear me ramble, the TLDR of the entire video is fuck College Board, fuck A-Push, I love my A-Push teacher, and fuck College Board. The godforsaken course known as AP United States History is too much content for people to reliably remember and get fives on. Now I can only speak from experience as I've taken, as of the recording of this audio, two other APs, AP World as a sophomore and AP English Lang as a junior. I took AP Lang the same year as A-Push, so let's dive into the issue, starting with the thread that made everyone pissed. On June 22nd, the 2023 AP US History scores were released. Well, not the actual scores themselves, rather just the percentages. The percentages of students who got 5s on the exam were 11%, 4s were 15%, 3s were 22%, 2s 23%, and the number of 1s a whole 29%! In order to pass an AP exam, you need a score of 3 or higher. That means a good majority of the people who took the exam this year failed it, and 74% of them didn't earn college credit. Now I know what you might be thinking.
Threes are still a good score. Why did you include threes in your percentage calculation?
Lots of colleges don't think that way. A lot of colleges do not accept threes for college credit. You either need to get a 4 or 5 on the correlating AP exam. There are some exceptions to this, i.e. BC Calc, but we're not talking about BC Calc here. And guess what? A-Push isn't one of them. The part of the thread that really grinds my gears is the tweet that states, "By far, the most challenging period for AP United States History students was Unit 2. The average score on these questions was 49%. Which, I don't know what Trevor's expecting here. Considering the exam content page states that periods 1 and 2 make up 8 to 10% of the exam. It's almost like the website is indirectly telling you not to study it. Many people made the argument on Twitter that America didn't exist during that time period, which, yeah, fair point, but at the same time, I see why it's important to know the context behind the nation at large, though most of period 2 just felt like an AP World History recap. Oh, but that's not even the best part. At the end of the thread, he states, "Curious why AP World History and Euro History scores are higher than A-Push scores?" Like it's some sort of rhetorical question. Keep in mind, the first time I saw this tweet was at 2 in the morning when I was looking through my friend's Snapchat story and they posted that screenshot of the tweet being dropped.
Yeah, okay. Oh my god.
I offer a number of reasons. Number one, United States history is often a required course in high school to graduate, as is the case in my high school. You generally get a broader scope of students taking the course as opposed to AP Euro. At my school, AP Euro isn't even offered, and AP World History fulfills the graduation requirement for sophomore history class. Most people may not want to take an AP in their first 2 years of high school, and A-Push might be their first experience with an AP Humanities class, given that there is no other AP Humanities class that one can take as a sophomore other than AP World. Everything I just said applies to my school in particular, as any other AP Humanities class, like for example AP Psychology is a really popular one with kids, you have to be a junior to take that. Two, and this is the biggest point that have been brought up by other people, A-Push is just too much for a 3-hour exam. Let me put this in a simpler way, right? AP World is the bigger picture, and A-Push is the bigger picture plus each of the little threads that make the tapestry. If you haven't taken A-Push yourself, you've probably heard this statement from other people who have. You know, A-Push, more like notes-taking class, which is kind of true, really, because with the amount of information that is presented in the A-Push textbook, I mean, some schools use AMSCO, my school uses Henretta, so, like, with all that information, How you finna remember that? Like, you're not gonna remember that. You have to take notes. It's, like, mandatory. Like, bro, you're not gonna remember that. Oh, my goodness. Before I get carried away, I also do want to mention, even though the College Board says that we can't discuss multiple choice answers or questions after the exam because they're never released, you know what? I'm gonna discuss them. But, hey, even if I remembered the entire thing completely, I wouldn't be able to tell you. Because, well, you know, I don't. I'm just gonna say this in a vague sense. Most of those questions were really vague, you know? They weren't on, like, the big ideas of American history. There were one or two questions about Reconstruction that I remember. Most of them were just on small, minute details across the periods and didn't really focus on any of the big talking points of each period, right? So, with that in mind, it's just like, man, you can't really expect people to, like, You would think that out of all the things you remember in English, you would remember the big ideas. But no, see, if you remember the big ideas, you were set up for failure because you walked into that test May 5th and you looked at it and you were like, what the fuck? This ain't got shit on big ideas, bruh. Bruh! Bruh! Now, while sorting through the quotes and replies on that Twitter thread, person A says, is this a joke? U.S. students are so stupid. That exam is a breeze. You can literally bullshit your way through the essays. Person B replies, although this doesn't excuse the fact that 74% of students got less than a 4, this point may offer an explanation for why the test scores were so bad. And they link a tweet from person C stating the following. These are the kids that did their 9th grade online. They missed a critical and foundational school year. Then their 9th grade year was offered in-person or hybrid, so lots stayed home again, and most did not take AP World. So for me, most came with little prep skills for A-push. And, you know, I don't really fault person C for this take. I think it's completely accurate to say the majority of the people who were taking A-push this year are juniors, or at this point, I guess, rising seniors, class of 2024! Because, you know, we did have our freshman year online, and I think a lot of us back then didn't really learn or, like, gain those strategies unless we took AP World the next year. So, you know. But then, person A replies to person B, saying, whose fault is it that the culture in America creates lazy, unmotivated students who can't do the basic academic things in high school necessary to get ahead in life? Online resources are more than enough to do well on these exams. There is so much free instruction out there. This is a pretty shit take, dog. Like, damn, this take is ass. I just know they sound like an uptight old-ass person who has never taken a push in their life. Jeez. It'd be one thing if this were, like, you know, 2020 and everybody's at home online or whatever. But even then, I don't encourage the betraying of academic integrity like that. But even so, it's just like, what the hell? My A-push teacher strongly suggested that we don't use online resources to do most of the learning because there's a lot of spots that can't be filled in with online resources. You know, I think some kids just learn better, you know, being taught by an actual person that's, like, in front of them, you know? Learning differences aside, my actual opinion on this is shared with a friend of mine. My friend, Bestie Westie Ethan, he said, AP itself is flawed in that they teach education in such a way to prepare someone for an exam that will not be relevant for the rest of their life. Like, it's good to learn shit for the sake of learning, but a lot of it will just not benefit you outside of indirect effects. The whole idea of America now creates lazy people is more so a reflection of how overworked and mistreated people of the past were, to the point where they saw it as normal. Also, they say bullshit the essays, and then they say use online resources. Pick a struggle. Whew, that video was long, huh? I bet you're sick of hearing my voice at this point, and the many pauses, and I'm sick of editing all of the stutters I made in this video. This is my first time doing, like, a commentary video. I might do more depending on what makes me angry and what applies to me as a human being. So, you know, thank you for watching the whole way through if you did. take care of yourselves, and to you, College Board,
suck my dick! Phone number. Oh my god, come on.
Bro cannot mind his craft. Oh my god.